Okay, we're moving on now. Sorry for the flashy screen. That's part of the reason why I had to do so much to get to the moon to actually pull up on OBS. For some reason, I had to do like screen capture, and it made like the rest of my computer screen look crazy. I did kind of break it. I did, but it's okay. It's fixed now. It's fixed now. So, next up is Braid. It is Caesar Bar, Caesar Radio. Sorry, I'm sorry, guys. Yep, detailing the Braid puzzle with Acorn Bandit. So, Braid is the one game that I actually have played. I beat it. It was, I think, my third game I ever streamed on Twitch. I played Portal 1, Portal 2, and then Braid. So it is a platform and puzzle game. It was released in 2008 for the Xbox 360 Live Arcade service, which I did not know. And then it was brought to the computer a year later in 2009. So Jonathan Blow, the game's designer, actually funded the entire project himself with his own money, and I think it took 2 years or 3 years. And he made it as like a personal critique to contemporary game development. What's cool about it is that it's so multifaceted. It looks extremely simple when you go in. You're literally solving puzzles, and you're learning about this guy Tim and all of his thoughts about. Music is loud. I'm sorry. Is that better? That's as loud as I usually have it. Sorry, guys. Sorry, guys. So yeah, you're this guy Tim, and you're looking for your girlfriend who is supposedly a princess, and you think he's completely shitting you. But you're going through all these levels, and like as you play the game, you uncover more and more about his like thoughts and his kind of like mental state. And there's lots of references. There's references to like Donkey Kong and all of these other early game pop culture references. But at a certain point, like when you get to the end of the game, at least for me, there came a point when I was like, oh my God, the amount of like psychological and sociological commentary in this game is a lot more than I thought. I thought it was just kind of stupid. Just because of like how Tim was thinking about things, like I ridiculed Tim a lot, I'll be honest. But by the end of the game, it's amazing. So I definitely recommend it. It's super fun. We're going to switch over to it now. Let me get it opened up. It does get a little tricky, actually. It is more, it's more puzzle based. So it was fun to play it on stream because I had chat to help me, but I did get stuck quite a lot. Also, a fun fact about Braid is that it's considered like a keystone title in the development of indie games. It was a really huge influence, and the creator, Jonathan Blow, his next game just came out last month, and it's called The Witness. And it's a similar concept where you're on an island, in this case, solving lots of different puzzles. So I'm probably gonna get it eventually. I'm gonna add to my wish list, wait for a sale or something. But if you like Braid, then you're probably gonna like the same, like The Witness, because it's from the same creator. So yeah. So we're gonna go over to Braid now. And we're gonna bring the oons music down. Okay. And here we go, and of course it's not syncing up at all. Excellent. Excellent. Let's try options, settings. I swear to God, this worked last night. Oh, I think I know why. Oh, I know why. Okay. Duh. There we go. I knew it worked last night. It was on the wrong thing. I had to set up three different game captures for these games, guys. Okay. Braid. Here we go. And back. Oh, right. I still have my controller plugged in, so we're just gonna use that. So the music is gorgeous. Easily my favorite soundtrack I've ever heard in a game, aside from like Final Fantasy X, which is my favorite game. So you get this really atmospheric opening, literally just running across a bridge. As you can see, the game is beautiful. I love the way it's been animated, very like painty. They come into this house, and you have all these different worlds to interact with. You can't really do anything right now. You can climb, go down here to the bathroom where it tells you about your keys, which I realized way too late. I think I was using my arrow keys, and then I came in here, I'm like, oh, WASD, oh, oops. But as you unlock the worlds, you get access to other worlds, and you have to build puzzles, literal puzzles, right here to unlock like a visual story. So we're gonna go into the first one. Is Braid that time game? It is a time game, Jerry Springer. You found me on Twitch when I was playing Braid, didn't you? Yep, we're going back for it. Back to bed for me. Acorn is too much party for too early. Shut up, T. No alerts? No, guys, I'm streaming on someone else's channel. I don't have alerts set up. If you are following me, or if you're watching me now and you want to follow me, just go over to my channel, twitch.tv/acornbandit to follow me. Otherwise, you're going to be following CubeTubers, which is awesome because we're going to be streaming from this channel whenever we do events like this. You'll always like know when we're going live. But yeah. Done with To the Moon? Sweet, now I can watch. What? Thorniest, do not like To the Moon? You have 50 in your scene? What, 50 game captures, T? Jesus. It's not the... I know, Doggy. We are going into World 2, because we don't have access to World 1 until later. But hey, Thorniest. That was way earlier. What was way earlier, Jerry Springer? Alright, so 2, Time and Forgiveness. Tim is off on a search to rescue the princess. She has been snatched by a horrible and evil monster. This happened because Tim made a mistake. Not just one, he made many mistakes during the time they spent together, all those years ago. Memories of their relationship have become muddled, replaced wholesale, but one remains clear. The princess turning sharply away, her braid lashing at him with contempt. So after I played this on stream the first time, her braid lashing him with contempt became an inside joke for a very long time, because it's such a funny mental image. A braid lashing with contempt. Okay, moving on. He knows she tried to be forgiving, but who can just shrug away a guilty lie and stab in the back? Such a mistake will change a relationship irreversibly, even if we have learned from the mistake and would never repeat it. The princess's eyes grew narrower, she became more distant. Our world, with its rules of causality, has trained us to be miserly with forgiveness. By forgiving too readily, we can be badly hurt. But if we've learned from a mistake and become better for it, shouldn't we be rewarded for the learning rather than punished for the mistake? What if our world worked differently? Suppose we could tell her, I didn't mean what I just said, and she would say, it's okay, I understand. And she would not turn away, and life would really proceed as though we had never said that thing. We could remove the damage but still be wiser for the experience. Tim and the princess lounge in the castle garden, laughing together, giving names to the colorful birds. Their mistakes are hidden from each other, tucked away between the folds of time, safe. Alright, and then we're going to go into the first level. So part of the reason why I ridiculed Tim so much the first time I played it is because of those passages like that. I read a lot, and just the switching of tenses, past, present, and the different points of view, it drove me crazy. And I kind of belittled them a little bit, but then later you see that there's a lot of thought that goes into those passages. Alright, so we can jump, and we can rewind time. So literally, if I run across here, and then rewind time, it will repeat everything I just did. They use this concept to get through the levels. You can also climb, similar to what we had to do in Fez. What are you telling me to do? Just move over, I guess. Alright, so we have to get these puzzle pieces, and as you can see on the top left-hand corner of the screen, we have 3 puzzle piece outlines, and we have to fill those up for each level. We have these Goombas! They're not actually Goombas, but we called them Goombas, and so forever they will be Goombas to me, because you have to kill them like that. Remember how I said there's a lot of references to other video games? I feel like this is a Mario reference. Also, the, Oh shit. also the cannon, too. But they will kill you if you get too close to them. Alright, I think I have to do a double jump for this. Crap. I'm gonna have to wait for them to get synced up. I didn't watch The Moon because I haven't played it yet and don't want to spoil it for myself. Okay. It's really good, Thornius. You should definitely play it. Okay. Ah, damn. Alright, I think I know what to do now. Anyone from my chat from the time period that I played this game can attest to how much time I spent, crap, rewinding to get these stupid puzzle pieces. I need to do this. There we go. Got it. Okay, I'm just gonna go this way so I don't die. Because if you die, there's no restart. You literally have to rewind and then get out of the way. Alright, got all of our puzzle pieces, and now we get to go on to the next one. That background is really trippy. I know, it kind of is, right? It's very watercolor-y. So we have to get our key over here to unlock this door. So see, here's a good example. Now I have to rewind and try again. Use our key, take our cloud bridge over. And here's where we can actually put our puzzle together. So let's go in. Oops. It's weird, I haven't done this with a controller before. I think that goes there. But as you can see, or hear in this case, the music is beautiful. It's very like Celtic-ish, really gentle. I love it so much. I think this goes down here. I don't think we're going to be able to put too many pieces together until we go through the other areas. I think this is actually all I can do right now. Yep, I think so. So we're going to go out and we're going to move on. Because I know I actually can't get over that until I do something later. So we're going to move on and then come back. Okay, this is also an example of timing. Oh shit. No, come back, Goomba! Because you have to do this in a certain... oh no, wait a second. I need that other Goomba. As you can see, the one that's on top of the rock, I'm gonna have to jump down from there and bounce off the Goomba to get across to the other side. No! Oh my god, I almost died. No. Crap, I'm moving too far over. Come on. Oh my god. Okay, we're just gonna do this. There we go. Now I got him. Raised one of those games I avoided because of the art style, and I feel I missed out on something great. Should really go get it. You really should. It is beautiful and awesome, like Liliana said. It's a lot of fun. Okay, gotta time this right. Nope. That's all I need to do. And then we're gonna kill the last Goomba and then be able to go through to the puzzle piece. If I can aim. Nope. There we go. Alright, got our puzzle piece, and the next area is down here. Ikoran, do you have access to the Twitch inbox? For this account? No, I do not. Only my admins do. Yeah, I'm not sure which Twitch inbox you're talking about. I'm guessing you're talking about the inbox for... Yeah, there we go. For the account, but I don't. So if I make any of this look easy, it's because I spent hours and hours of my life playing this game. Come on. Oh my god. Go. So I do remember a lot of the challenges. Oh, I hated this one. Oh my god. Okay. This is extremely hard because you have to jump over. Nope. Nope. Damn. Okay. Oh my god, the timing. Oh my god, the timing. Oh, so close. So close. Almost. There we go. Got it. Okay, that took me forever the first time. Yeah, that works. I tried playing Braid a couple years ago, but had a hard time getting into it. What did you like about Trademark? Because there was a lot that I didn't really get either. I think having a chat with me helped. Crap. Playing it with people was nice, because they helped me, get through the levels and stuff, and give me... I think I'm hitting the wrong button for jump. I'm trying to jump off with this. Damn it. Okay. How did I fall perfectly that last time? I don't know. There we go. Okay. Like you're dancing with Braid. It does become kind of a dance after a while. I think this is the first time I watched you play with the time pausing and key and cannons. Is it Centria? Was it really that long ago? Oh man, I didn't realize that. Holy hell, this game would make me rage. I like the art style, animation, and gameplay. Fuck, I don't like the game. Oh well. You know, not every indie game is for everyone. If you do like puzzles and, you know, the concepts like this, and it's really fun, if you don't, that's okay. Okay, got the last one, and let's go. Also, does that look familiar to anyone? Piranha plants? They can kill you too, just like in Mario. And wait for it. It's a dinosaur. I'm sorry, but the princess is in another castle. Seem familiar? Alright, so now we can continue on with our puzzle making. Let's see. Okay, we're gonna keep that over there. Already we see there's some hanky-panky going on in the garden here. Someone's having fun with their wine. Alright, so what's really cool about this is we can now use this to get our other ones. Because as you can see, we have two puzzle pieces we haven't gotten in the second level. And you know, it might actually be fine. It might be good that you guys don't want to play this game, or a lot of people don't, because then I'm not going to be ruining this for you. Once again, it took a long time and chat to figure out what to do in this level, and it's pretty ingenious. Okay, the cardboard dinosaur is pretty cute. He's very cute. The terrain and backgrounds are pretty nice, but the characters and stuff are a real turnoff for you. Like I said before, at the beginning, I was ridiculing Tim and everyone else hardcore. It was fun, mainly because I could mock the game, which may not be the greatest, but then by the end, it really grew on me, and I was a fan. Alright, come on. If you can see, I'm trying to make a bridge, which is ingenious. Oh no. Back, back, back. No! Back! Come back, come back. Crap. You do it again. I think that'll work. Need to get him to come down here. Nope. A little lower. There we go. Is this like when Gandalf died and came back all white and shit? What did you do with Acorn? Hey, Nose Nose! I'm part of the CubeTuber community, and we're doing an indie game weekend, which is why I'm over here today. There we go. Oh crap, he's gonna have to come back. Which is why no Dark Souls today, Nose Nose. We'll get back to our fun soul times soon. Alright, come on, Goomba. There we go. Oh, wait, no! I need you to come back. I need you for the puzzle piece over here. Crap. There we go. That's it. Yep. Crap. This is why this game is so hard at points, because you have to get timing right with time travel. Okay. There we go. So he's moving this direction. All right, here's my chance. Here's like my one chance. I have to go back over here, get on top of that thing again. Nosy. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Canada! Oh my god. You know, Doggy, I saw your notes on Discord about, you know, like, oh, how many times do you think Acorn's gonna take to get the next boss, and then you come back and you're like, Acorn's not streaming Dark Souls, just doing some indie thing. It's so funny. It's okay, guys. Respect the indie games. Gotta make time for all games. Here we go. I thought the puzzles were a nice touch in this game, too. No, it definitely has to be like this. Here we go. Am I missing one? Oh, there you are. Alright, there's our puzzle, guys. Like I said, hanky-panky's happening in the garden. Someone's getting tipsy and having some smexy times. right, so that is, how do I go back to exit current world, go to the clouds, yep. There we go, got all of our stuff, guys. So that is world 2. And as you can see, our puzzle has been made. And now we're gonna go on to world 3. As you can see also, this is not in order. World 1 is later. I don't know why, I think it's in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen. But as we unlock each world, we learn a little bit more about Tim and about the world. I done did it. I actually remember the first couple worlds. This is not gonna be too bad. Alright, time in mystery. All those years ago, Tim had left the princess behind. He had kissed her on the neck, picked up his travel bag, and walked out the door. He regrets this to a degree. Now he's journeying to find her again, to show he knows how sad it was, but also to tell her how it was good. Tim's weird. For a long time, he thought they had been cultivating the perfect relationship. He had been fiercely protective, reversing all his mistakes so that they would not touch her. Likewise, keeping a tight rein on her own mistakes, she always pleased him. Does this sound like Twilight to anybody else? Like, this, controlling, fiercely protective relationships where everyone is guarding their own actions does not sound like a very healthy relationship. Much less perfect. But to be fully couched, again these words, but to be fully couched within the comfort of a friend is a mode of existence with severe implications. To please you perfectly, she must understand you perfectly. Thus, you cannot defy her expectations or escape her reach. Her benevolence has circumscribed you, and your life's achievements will not reach beyond the map she has drawn. If anyone else gets the end of this and goes, what? You're not alone. A lot of this is like this. It's like Tim's stream of consciousness. It's just whatever poetic language he attempts to write. When I first played this game, I likened it to a self-important teen fiction novel. It kind of sounds like someone who like has written a manuscript that is very self-important. Yeah. Tim needed to be non-manipulable. He needed a hope of transcendence. He needed, sometimes, to be immune to the princess's caring touch. Off in the distance, Tim saw a castle where the flags flutter even when the wind has expired and the bread in the kitchen is always warm. A little bit of magic. Alright. Any idea how long this game is? So we have 5 or 6 levels. And as you can see, each level has a different amount of levels within them. The one we just did was 4, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I think I played this over 5 or so 4-hour streams, I think, when I first played it. So probably 20 to 50 hours, depending on how slow or fast you do the puzzles, I would say. The Goomba picked up the key, and the key is glittering, glittering green, which, as you can see, means it's going to travel with us. Yay, now we got our key. We can unlock this and go through the door. So with every level, it kind of introduces a new game mechanic. This, of course, is going to be the fact that you can take things with you through time. What's hard, though, is some of these little gates are not magicked, so when you unlock them and you go back in time, they relock, but your key might break, which makes things difficult. Twilight got, oh god, this one's also difficult. Come on, Tim, faster, Tim. Now we're gonna travel back in time, and the key's gonna come with us. Ah, Indie Week, a week where you get to pat small developers in the back encouragingly while you secretly wish you were playing something else. For some people, there's also a very, very strong indie community that prefers indie games. I'm an equal game opportunist. I play all the things. There's so many good indie games I could and have spent all day playing, though. Yeah, what Lily said. I'm joking, mostly. I just got over a massive Don't Starve addiction, so I'm not immune. Dude. Oh my god, Don't Starve. Addiction is real with Don't Starve. Oh no, oh no. I need to play me some more Don't Starve. Crap. Crap. That's right. The green clouds don't go back in time, but I go back in time. Oh crap, nope. So I need to make a sky bridge. Okay. No. almost. Yay! Got it. Okay, we're good. This game does have interesting aesthetic. I think so too. It's like a like or hate type of thing, I think. Some people would like it, some others wouldn't. I certainly have never seen game mechanics like this before. This whole puzzle concept with time, it just gets more and more difficult. There we go, got our two. And let's move on. I feel like such a pro. I just have to say, like, having beaten this game, I feel like such a pro right now. It's great. I'm usually not. I'm usually the one who spends like 4 hours. Oh crap, it's right, I need that Goomba. The rise of indie games is the best thing to happen in video games ever, in your opinion. All I have to say is Minecraft and the argument is over, for real. Oh, that's right. I need to activate this. There we go. He needs to get the key for me. Go. This music is so nostalgic for me, though, having spent so many hours playing this game. Oh, that's right. That's right. Okay, so I need to do this. And then go back. Here's another weird mechanic. You can go through objects as if you were on top of them. There you go, like that. Really strange. And then I can walk back. And then go back down again. And I have my key. This takes a lot of critical thinking. You have to really think about, okay, well, if this moves this way, this time, then okay, I need to come here, and then I have to reverse or rewind. There's one level that has you go through an entire maze to get a key. It has like a thing. Oh god. Oh god, the rabbits. So I personally think the rabbits are a Monty Python reference. I could be wrong, but they are rabid flower bunnies. And I hate them. They're so hard to kill. At least they were with my mouse and keyboard back when I played this game. Oh god. It's easier with the controller. So many times, Yeah, Undertale and a couple of the games like that are really, oh, this part, okay. Have to save the Goomba. Goomba! Crap. So I have to be standing up here. But yeah, Undertale and a couple of those games, those are like really simple, and I kind of, I don't know if I like the style very much either. I probably wouldn't play them myself. Crap. No! Damn it. But I know Undertale is incredibly popular. No, these Goombas are dying. Where are you? Where are you? There you are. Okay, there we go. This works. Yay! More bunnies! Oh god, bunny attack! Ah! Crap. There we go. Piranha plant got him. Bunny horde. Oh my god, bunny horde. Oh my god, oh my god. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, no! These stupid bunnies. The small ones are really hard too. To get. Oh my god, I can't believe I just killed them. That was amazing. Alright. I play pixel games, can't handle the ones trying to mimic the very old ones though. The ones that are like super old school looking, that kind. Okay, how did I do this again? I forget. I would have never played Undertale had it not been for the massive art, purely because of its art style. But now that I've played it, I actually can't say I dislike the art. Oh, massive hype, yeah. Its art style is Earthbound, mother-based though. Well, yeah, people are super nostalgic about games in the first place, doggy, and then if they played, like, 8-bit and 16-bit games as kids, it's just like, I don't know, it's full of all warm fuzzies, I guess. Now, fuck those bunnies, I know. Fuck those bunnies. I can't remember how to do this part, guys. Trine is drop dead gorgeous. You just figured the puzzle out, Crystal Wolf? Give me a hint because I forget how to do this, and usually I think it's. I have to do something with the time. They're not green, which means I can't control them. How did I do this? Nope, not fast enough. I can't jump up either. There's no Goombas to use to get up there. Have to run through, but in order for me to run through, yep, I can't remember. Now I want to see Acorn playing. I want to be the Boshi. What What's I Wanna Be the Boss? Yeah, I haven't heard of that before. Hello, UBC? USB? I don't know why I said that. USB, hello. You just got here to watch me be stuck. Does my shirt say bling? Does mine? No, mine says, bring back Pluto. It has a, like, space inside the letters. Because Pluto's a planet, we all know it. We all know Pluto's a planet. Let's just bring it back already. Oh, God. I'm so close! Hi again, I love Braid. Hey, Throck, welcome back! If you love Braid and you can help me with this, that'd be great. I can't remember how to get through here. And these are not green fireballs, so I can't control them. I forget. Oh god, Ellie. Bling would have been funnier. It would have been funnier, but less nerdy, I guess. Pluto matters. Pluto matters more than bling. That's fine. I need to die once? But it's not gonna get me across. Oh, you're so right. Oh my god. I don't know why that happened. Oh, gotcha. Okay, because it opened up the space because the fireball was gone. There you go. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you. 15 minutes left. How far can we get, guys? Oh! Stupid bunny. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, shit. Death everywhere! Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. Oh! So I actually need to... Crap. That's right, I need to go to the beginning of the level now. Jesus. There's a green, platform? Yeah, is it green? So much death. Fuck. So much death. Here we go. You stupid bunnies. Here we go. I have to get the horizontal platform across before the green one comes across. So I need to go up here. I believe... How do I do this again? Let me think. The green one's going up, and the horizontal one needs to go across. And I need to... make sure it can go across in time. I think actually it's going to now. Nope. Crap, when does it start going across? I don't know what activates it. Let me see. Basically, I can't time travel, I think. If I can just not time travel, it'll go across in time. Fuck. Well, there you go. But why do the bunnies meow? That is the ultimate question of Braid, Crystal Wolf. That is the question that plagued me my entire playthrough. Why do the bunnies meow? I don't know. I feel like that is a very strange decision to have, or to make, for bunnies. there we go. See? Okay, so now the platform's going across. So we can go across it as well to get our puzzle piece. They just gave us lots of adversaries to make sure that we had a hard time not rewinding. There we go. I just got here. Don't really recognize the level. It's okay, Throck. We figured it out. Yep, that was the case. We had to get hit by one of the fireballs, rewind back in time, and then run where the empty spot was to get to the ladder in time. It's probably a... Jaubitz? Jaubitz? Oh no! Oh no! Okay. Let's try that again. Okay, we're good. We're good. We can continue. I know you're a bunny. I know you're a bunny. Don't mess with me. There you are. Stupid bunnies. Come on, Acorn. This isn't the pursuer. I know. I know. I'm shaming myself. Okay. Actually, I don't know. Yes, okay, good. Then we can pick up the key again and use it a second time to get this. Crap. He wasn't even there. There are two fireballs being shot. Yeah. Yep. Your reflexes have gotten better since, though. In Dark Souls, they have. Indeed, they have. You should have seen me, doggy. Did some practice. I was wrecking face. It was great. Alright. I need to... Crap. I did not mean to do that. Darn it, no. I think I have to restart the level now. Crap. Yes. Go back to the clouds. No, God. Oops. All right. Exit current world. Yep, do it again. Shit. Well, no. I mean, like in this game, do you remember watching you play this and dying all over the place? Did you? Wait, when did you find me, doggy? Did you find me that long ago when I was playing Braid? Shit. I cleared it. No! Oh my god! 24 hours, AVG. I do not want to restart right now. Holy crap. There we go, got him. Come here, bunny. Gotcha. The first time I came into your strum was when you were playing that survival game on your toaster. Oh my god, memories! Guys who aren't familiar with my streaming, my channel, I started streaming last year in August on a crappy old laptop, and we played some old games like Portal and games that my toaster could handle. But it was indeed a toaster. It could barely handle anything. Ah! But doggy, I didn't realize it was that long ago. Oh my god. No, why am I going over here? I already did this. Crap. Oh well. Okay, now we need to go and get our keys in the right order. Ah, shit, just walked right into him. There we go. And we're coming up. Wow, it has been 4 hours already, guys. We are coming up to the time when I'm gonna cut the stream. Hopefully this gave you a good idea of what Braid is all about. I think a nice thing about Indie Weekend is that it gives you a chance to look at gameplay without necessarily buying the game yourself, so you can see if it's something that you enjoy. I've heard a couple people say they don't really like the art style and everything else in here, but if you do like the game, definitely go get it, because it's fun. It's a brain bender. You feel very accomplished when you get to the end. Go on a journey with Tim. Learn some stuff. Find the princess. It's a good time. You were sitting by the fire because it lagged so much, couldn't do anything. Oh man, was I playing... Holy crap, no doggy, you came in when I was playing Savage Lands. No, my computer could not handle Savage Lands. Lely, if you're still here, that was with you. I was dual streaming with you. Computer could not handle Savage Lands at all. It was freaking out. So I had to just sit by the fire while everyone else went hunting without me. It was so sad. Okay, so the green keys break. That's right, which is why I have to do this. There we go. Okay, perfect timing. We finished our level. Now we can go back to the house. And you know what? We can actually just do that from... No, I'm not going to chance it. I'm going to go forward. I don't remember if it gets rid of my puzzle pieces or not. There we go. We can get the puzzle pieces here. Quick puzzle time together, guys. It was too savage. The game was too savage for it. Couldn't even handle it. But guys, I think Lily Nyon is next after me. I didn't see what she was playing. He or she, I don't know who they are, but hang tight. We have lots more coming up on Indie Weekend. I think we're running for... God, no, actually we're running until Sunday. Lots of time. Lots of games to come. But I hope you enjoyed watching me play through the games that I had. I played these because I had them. And I hope it was enjoyable for you. Like I said earlier, if you want to follow me, a lot of my channel over on Acorn Bandit is me playing new games that I haven't played before. All kinds of games, so we have a good time over there. We're all about raccoons, so if you're all about raccoons, we'll be friends. Yep, 2 minutes to go. Alright, so I'm going to quit now. Yeah, quit Braid. Exit. And, there we go. Yep, that is it. So, as we go out, let you know when to take over. Squishy-doo, I am all done. It's all yours. You're up next. She's in with me for a co-op game. Sweet. Thanks, everybody. Thank you for hanging out with me. I hope it was fun. Hope you enjoy. Feel free to try all these games. Let me know how you, what you think about them. And maybe I'll see you around. Bye.